our last film, we explored how the introduction of self-driving cars is likely to kill a lot of jobs. Many millions of jobs, in fact. But is it short-sighted to view self-driving vehicles as economic murderers? Is it possible that we got it totally wrong, and automated vehicles won't be grim reapers, but rather the biggest job creators since the internet? When cell phones first arrived, people feared that everyday life would soon be filled with incessant ringing and a constant public din of loud mouths shouting into bulky rectangles. These predictions were not misguided, but they were incomplete. For example, the one activity that is conspicuously rare in most people's time on a cell phone today, talking to people via audio. Reality ended up going in a different direction. Just as cell phones ended up not having much to do with verbal communication, perhaps, when combined with human nature, automated vehicles will lead to totally unpredicted shifts in everyday life. Now, to be clear, some of the ideas we are about to present will seem whimsical and ridiculous. The vision of self-driving cars we laid out in our previous video certainly seemed a lot more plausible. But as Arthur C. Clarke liked to point out, a vision of the future that seems reasonable is almost always wrong. So perhaps it is worth it to drive down a few implausible roads. Let's begin. The most common vision of a self-driving future is one in which a few car companies own large, centralized fleets of vehicles. But doesn't this seem a little too clean for reality? Hordes of indistinguishable vehicles seems a little boring and dystopian. So let's envision a future instead, where the big companies make base platforms and an enormous new industry develops around smaller companies building customized fleets of office cars, sleeping cars, hot tub cars, pet-friendly cars, cinema cars, gaming cars, yoga and meditation cars, etc. Some cars might even be modular enough to frequently return to facilities, where the interior would be reconfigured according to upcoming customer purchases. And while bumper stickers might be a relic of car ownership, companies looking for an edge might cover their cars in as many looks as an army of art designers can imagine, with a lot of advertising and corporate tie-in, of course, so that when a customer is ordering a ride, they can arrive in exactly the style that they prefer. Let's add one more type of car to that list that we mentioned earlier. Bar cars. As in alcohol. That's right, with driving obsolete, so is the DUI. The alcohol industry could get a big boost. Although, be warned, if puking in cars becomes too much of an epidemic, prepare to see the birth of the RUI. Riding under the influence. And let's take this customized car thing a step further. A number of services that you currently receive at locations could suddenly become services that are done while you go to a location. Getting your nails done, or even getting your hair cut, although I wouldn't recommend that when you're on a bumpy road. We aren't done yet. If there is one thing that televisions and cell phones have demonstrated conclusively, it's that humans love to stare at glowing screens. And with self-driving cars, we will have a lot more time to do just that. It's hard to imagine there being even more television, games, and other entertainment being produced than there already is today. But self-driving cars could put entertainment job growth into overdrive. Autonomous vehicles could kill off many hotels, but here too there is another possibility. Because self-driving cars could increase the amount of overall traveling that people do, many areas that are currently considered the middle of nowhere might become the middle of somewhere. Speaking of hotels, things are about to get weird. Sex and self-driving cars could be a lucrative match. Putting illicit activities aside, in some parts of the world, most notably Japan, a hospitality industry called Love Hotels offer brief access to specialized rooms. This trend has never taken off in the United States, but perhaps self-driving cars could bring in a similar industry, albeit in mobile form. In a completely unrelated topic, cleaning. If users of self-driving cars don't own their vehicles, they will have far lower tolerances for the amount of dirt, grime, and general grossness that they will tolerate on their rides. Self-driving vehicles will need to report to facilities for cleaning and refurbishment frequently. Whether that work will be done by humans or yet more machines is an open question. Most radically, automated vehicles might open up new industries that have very little to do with destinations. An RV with no driver would be a pure living environment. traveling at home could become a real phenomenon, and futurist FM 2030's concept of the Mobilia, traveling ad hoc communities that he predicted would replace towns, could even move from the pages of science fiction to reality. So, what do you think self-driving cars will do to the economy and our habits and daily lives in general? Will either of the visions we've presented become reality? Or will these predictions soon look as silly as a 1950s flying car? We hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to like, subscribe, comment, and check out our Patreon page. See you next time.